Second half, first half wasn't even close, guys, and we'll see if there is a comeback on our hands or more of the same as we get the third quarter started. An exceptional performance from John Wall.
Yeah, the magic touch with the ball. He just made great decisions, piling up the assists there in the first half, and really doing a nice job for his teammates.
You know, it isn't a very common occurrence, Steve. Typically, he's more likely to be on the receiving end of the pass, but so far, it's been the other way around here.
So on the floor for Washington, Wall and Beal together in the backcourt, Pearson and Nene filling up the forward spots, and it's Gortat in at the five. Now here's Wall, dishes it to Beal. Here's Nene. The jumper's good from inside 6 feet. Nene's got the opening bucket to start the second half for Washington. And the Hornets with possession here, down by 15. Wall against Walker. He feeds it to Stevenson. Pass to Jefferson. Down to five on the shot clock. Gortat with the rebound.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be. Firmly in control of this game.
Yep, they have not let their guard down one bit in the paint.
Now here's Beal, and Wall kicks to Gortat. From the baseline, and Washington again with the bucket.
They're perfectly content to keep going to that mid-range jumper. If the defense is going to give it to them, they'll take it all day.
Yeah, why not? I mean, you have to just take what's there, and as long as you're moving the ball and getting good shots, that's all that matters.
Walker's shot is off.
Well, Paul Pierce is listed now at 6'7", 206. Either somebody was lying or he grew. Either way, he's got a big body. And he's a very good rebounder for a small forward and knows how to use his big body at the defensive end. He actually played power forward much of last season.
Here's Walker after marching Gortat's bucket. Jefferson setting the pick for Walker. Outside, Kid Gilchrist. And Pierce over to help. Here's Stevenson. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Lance Stevenson, a most improved candidate for the Pacers last season, and he said vehemently that he was staying with the Pacers despite his impending free agency. But something must have changed. Not quite sure exactly what it was. He ended up taking a deal with the Hornets for less guaranteed money. I think partly driven to get to the end of that second contract quickly.
And the Pacers offered Stevenson, I think, 5 years and about $44 million. He signed with the Hornets for less, 3 years and just over $27
million. Yeah, you know, it's not like the Hornets blew the Pacers off the table with their offer financially. I mean, so I've got to think there was something more to Lance's decision, and part of it may have been desiring a bigger role. It's been a solid outing for Stevenson. 13 points, and he's put one three-pointer on the board.
Yeah, he's got to take his time behind the arc.
That would be four in a row for them now as they have come racing out of the gate to start this second half.
Hornets trail by 20. Walker dishes to Jefferson. Jefferson, a screen on Beal. Charlotte moving it around. And Jefferson wide open. He shoots. Rebounded by the Wizards. Nene's got 7 rebounds in the game.
Physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. That plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Yeah, not to mention what it says on the scoreboard. I mean, they're really pushing them around physically at this point.
Charlotte calls timeout.
Nene, I think, an underrated defensive player. Not a big shot blocker, but he has tremendous size and strength, and he can move laterally. So he can really move and cover the pick and roll and switch on to guards, an effective defender.
For Charlotte, they've gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second half. And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. Jefferson with the bucket, getting it done inside. Jefferson's got 17.
And Nene, for his size and agility, at times somewhat disappointing in terms of rebounding the ball. Throughout his career, actually, his rebound rate has fallen steadily over the last 3 years. Maybe injuries a factor in that, but they do need more from him on the glass.
Washington calls timeout. We talk about the subtle decline for Nene. Is scoring efficiency, Steve, also taking a turn for the worse over the last couple seasons?
Yeah, still in his early 30s. You know, age shouldn't be that big a factor for a big man, but I guess it's the accumulation of all those injuries, including his knee sprain last season, that may be taking their toll.
Now here's Wall. He's got 19. For the past few seasons, the Wizards have been making trades almost every season, but they stuck with their roster last year, and Clark, it paid off.
It sure did, Kevin. You could see how they continued to grow into a really tight-knit, cohesive group over the season, and that always makes a difference.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Hey, guys. I got a chance to hear what Steve Clifford was saying to his team. He thinks there are opportunities for second-chance points out there and implored them to go hard to the offensive glass for the remainder of this game. The second thing he got into with them regarded getting the ball into the post, saying, quote, "The passing lanes will be open for us. We have to use that to our advantage and get the ball inside." Well, they need to make something happen before the start of the fourth quarter, and maybe those changes will do the trick, Kevin.
All right, Doris, thanks. And so Wall nails both of them. For Charlotte, they've gotten just one of their first four shots to fall since coming out of the locker room at the break. Stevenson setting the pick for Walker. Stevenson against Pierce. And Walker kicks to Stevenson. Just four to shoot. The shot is off. And Washington the other way now.
And some stability for this franchise, which had seen some ups and downs over the past few years. Nice to have a foundation for the Wizards to build off of.
We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now. Wall with it. He's got 21. The pass to Beal. Walker against Wall. Six on the shot clock. Three-pointer. Here's Gortat. Jefferson with the rebound. Charlotte has gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Against Walker. Kidd Gilchrist, a screen on Beal. Stevenson against Beal. Fires from the wing. There's the bucket. Good. And that's 13 points now in the game for Walker.
And if you look at how Washington has set themselves up, the Wizards should be in a good place for a long time. I mean, they only have to make some minor adjustments to the roster as they have the major pieces in place, particularly that backcourt. John Wall, Bradley Beal, that's a keeper of a backcourt for a long time.
Hornets trail by 20. He dishes it to Kidd Gilchrist. Walker goes in, shot from 12. That drops. Walker's got 15 points.
I like the way they're working the ball inside because when you do that, you get higher percentage shots and typically good things happen.
Walker against Wall. He kicks it to Beal. It's Pierce on the wing. Fires it up. And again, Washington, no good. Hornets have gone 3-7 on field goal attempts here in the second half. Stevenson setting the pick for Walker. Back to Stevenson. Stevenson left side. Here's Walker. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. It's going to be on John Wall.
Walker having a fantastic game.
He has 15 points, and he's done his job at the charity stripe. He's gotten 4 of his points from there.
And that's a good place to get them. You know, they don't come easier than that, but you've got to get yourself there first.
And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Wizards?
Boy, their passing has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
And another thing they're doing is really taking advantage of fast break opportunities, scoring some easy baskets.
Vonleh's checked in for the Hornets. Andre Miller's checked in for Washington. Kemba Walker hits them both.
He has such terrific form and consistency on his free throws. Beautiful to watch.
Miller outside. Gortz out with a screen on Walker. Beal gets a wide open look. His three-pointer's off the mark.
Can get it to fall.
But Steve, they'll take that play all day long, 10 times out of 10. That was good action.
Now here's Walker. He's got 17. Jefferson against Gortat. Shoots from the right block. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
Obvious foul.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
The Hornets have shot 9 of 11 at the free throw line.
Well, guys, you go back to last season. This is a team that hit just 74% of its free throws. I know they'd like to see that number go up.
And I know the free throw shooting is an area they focused on improving coming into this season.
Free throw good, Jefferson.
Well, really nice to see the purple and teal back on the court with Charlotte reclaiming the Hornets as their team identity. And I like the new jerseys. Not too bad at all. Pretty fashionable there.
So he gets them both. And the Hornets for Charlotte, a reference to the fighting spirit in the region during the American Revolution.
Yeah, the region compared to a hornet's nest by the British generals. And the new logo, a little edgier than the last one. We'll see if they can channel some of that ferocity on the court.
Out of bounds. Charlotte takes possession. And the Wizards making a change here. Humphreys checked in. And here's Charlotte. Big stretch here going 10-2. And clearly, Steve Clifford wants to talk it over. Now, here's Vonleh, looking for his first basket still in this one. The feed now to Stevenson. Lock at 6. Outside, Walker. And again, the Hornets missing.
He's still looking for his first three-pointer of the second half after making just 1 in the first.
Walker against Miller. To the right side. Here's Nene. The Wizards with another miss. Here are the Hornets with the ball. They've gone on a 10-2 run, not allowing much. Right side to Walker. Outside, Kidd Gilchrist. Feeds to Stevenson. 5 to shoot. second chance shot. There it goes. It's in, and the Wizards' lead is cut down now to just 12 on the basket from Jefferson.
Boy, they are just destroying them in the paint.
You could say that again, Steve. The defenders just aren't aggressive enough down low.
Now, here is Miller. He has 7. Outside, Pierce. All sorts of time. It's rebounded by Jefferson. Jefferson's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. And Stevenson kicks to Walker. Stevenson passes to Jefferson. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
After a 5-year absence from the playoffs, the Wizards were able to get back into the postseason last year. Big step for the franchise.
And the Wizards certainly turned some heads in their postseason run. A team considered to be an afterthought in the playoffs, but they did as well as any could have hoped for in terms of getting to the second round and pushing the Pacers to 6 games in that round.
That free throw good from Jefferson. Well, with the Wizards, a good postseason run, taking care of business, beating Chicago in the first round, and then Clark put a scare into the Pacers in the second.
Exactly, Kevin. There was a rumor that some teams were trying to make it where they would face the Wizards in the playoffs, thinking they were weak and an easy opponent. Not sure if those rumors are true, and the Wizards certainly showed they're very formidable and will be good going forward.
He doesn't get the second one.
A big part of last year's turnaround in Charlotte was the team's ability to get the close game wins. I mean, they did that in this building, and typically they just found a way to stay at it and never give up.
Now here's Jefferson. He's got 22. And again, the Hornets missing. Beal against Williams. And that is... And it's the Hornets ball. They're on a 13-4 run. And for Charlotte, guys, you know, a lot of their 25 home wins were very close games, but they fought it out.
Yeah, if you actually look at their point differential at home, you wouldn't think they were very good in this building, but they came up clutch and won a lot of close games down the stretch last year.
Washington leading now by 13. Passes it to Porter. Kicks it to Beal. Miller dishes to Porter. Clock at 6. Wizards need to get a shot off here. Beal from long range. Jefferson with the rebound. Jefferson's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Alvanley. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change.
Well, I think he kind of alligator armed that one. Short stroked it. After doing a nice job to get open, he didn't finish the shot.
Miller, no up.
Had a pretty good look at the basket, but defensively they did a nice job rotating, forcing the miss.
And Neal kicks to Vonleh. Out of bounds, Washington takes possession.
I'll tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
Some changes for Charlotte. Biombo checks in for Jefferson, and Brian Roberts subbed in for Vonleh. Wizards leading by 13. Humphreys sets a pick for Miller. Pick by Humphreys. Pass to Beal. Back to Miller. Humphreys inside. And the rebound paying off as they pick up 2 on the second chance bucket right there.
Well, it's plays like that. Hustle, plays on the glass, and then staying with it, being active. It really caused some problems for that defense.
Now here's Henderson. 5 points in the game. Williams kicks to Biombo. And here's Henderson. 6 to shoot. They need this one. The dish to Neal. He feeds it to Roberts. Pass to Henderson. Williams, a screen on Porter. It's Henderson on the wing. Knocks down the 3 ball. Henderson's got 8.
Boy, he found the perfect spot behind the arc there.
Miller kicks to Beal. 46 seconds left to play here in the third, and he gets the bucket. Hornets trail by 14. Dishes to Henderson. Here's Roberts, covered by Miller. Henderson, no one around him. And a miss there on the triple. Washington's getting blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0 for 3. And that one's good by Porter.
Yeah, he put himself in great position to finish that break off, guys.
Yep, right to the rack.
Here's Roberts, covered by Miller. 14 feet away. Oh, that's blocked. To the inside. And finished off by Porter.
I like the fact that he led his teammate right to the ideal spots. You don't always throw it to your teammate. You throw it to where he needs to be.
Elbow shot is on the way. And he gets the jumper to drop. Henderson's got 5 points now this quarter. Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. Wizards lead by 16. And we're coming back in just a moment. Get ready for the fourth quarter of action when we return. Hornets trail by 16. A moment now to reset the lineups, brought to us by Gatorade. All fueled up here for the fourth quarter. And Charlotte looking at who they've got. Inside, Cody Zeller and Bismack Biyombo. Walker runs the point with Stevenson flanking him. And it's Henderson in at the three.
He's done a ton to help his team, guys. And he may have to do more if they're going to come back and win.
Here's Wall. Humphrey sets a pick for Bia. Gortz out with a screen on Stevenson. No one near Wall as he lets it go. And the three off target. Charlotte's gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly. Walker the pass to Zeller. Henderson with it. Now Beal defending. And Walker kicks to Stevenson. Just gets to the rim for two with the D all over him. Just over a minute played here in the fourth. All with it. Now the pass to Humphreys. Back to Wall. Walker with some nice D.
Well, he won't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions there.
Porter with the steal. Final quarter here, and we're just over a minute and a half through it. Humphrey sets a pick for Beal. Gortz out with a screen on Stevenson. Here's Porter. Shot clock at 6. That one's good from the corner. And the Wizards lead by 14.
You know, when he gets rolling, guys, he can be an absolute handful to have to deal with. And right now, he is rolling strong.
Now here's Walker. Now here's Zeller. Back to Walker. For three. Offensive rebound. Biyombo uses the glass to finish the layup.
If you battle for the offensive rebound and come up with it, you're guaranteed a high-quality shot on a follow just like he got there.
Gortat with a screen on Walker. Wall dishes to Gortat. And Wall kicks to Porter. Back to Wall. The Wizards working the ball around now. Henderson against Porter. From the arc. Again, the miss by Wall.
Well, in most games, he can knock it down from deep, but it just isn't there for him in this one.
The feed to Walker. He dishes it to Zeller. Back to Walker. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Walker's got 19 points.
Boy, what a display of offense we've seen today, and it's only getting better.
Well, both defenses have been on their heels all day, and it's begun to take its toll.
Now here's Beal. That's good. 26 points for him.
Well, this is what he does. He's shooting it well. He's scoring a lot of their points, getting them in front.
Stevenson outside. They set the pick. That ball. High speed that time from Stevenson. Stevenson's got 4 assists in the game. Wizards leading by 9. Outside, Wall. Beal against Stevenson. Beal, the pass to Wall. 6 on the shot clock. Count the bucket. Wall's got 23 points.
Well, it's kind of been the story here today, hasn't it, Clark?
For Charlotte, they've gone 5 of 6 from the field to start the fourth quarter on a roll. Zeller setting the pick for Stevenson. Anderson, no one around him. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Washington's gotten the three-point shot off 16 times tonight. 7 times they've hit it, 9 times they've missed. Wall against Walker. Unloads from 13. And again, John Wall. 25 points in the game. Hornets trail by 13. And it's Walker penetrating. Kicks it out to Stevenson. Back to Walker. Feeds to Stevenson. Passes it to Anderson. 6 to shoot. Stevenson outside. And Charlotte again with the bucket. So it's Washington now. Outside, Wall. He kicks to Beal. Shoots it up. Good D by Stevenson. Charlotte's gone past the three-point line for 13 of their shots. They're 6 of 13. Zeller setting the pick for Walker. And it's Zeller atop the key. Yambo dishes to Walker. Just 5 to shoot. Humphreys with the steal. Oh, and here we go. Wall's got it. The fast break chance. Outside for Beal. Looking for Gortat. He gets it there. Shot clock at 6. Beal with it. Al guarded by Stevenson.
Boy, Chris Humphreys is clearly not flashy, but he is a worker on and off the court. Has always been a strong rebounder, especially on the offensive glass, and never afraid to get in there and battle. He never shies away from contact. If you want.
And Humphreys, lightly regarded as a defender, but, you know, Steve, I think he made some strides last season.
I agree, Kevin. He blocked shots at a high rate. You know, in the past, he's struggled against the quicker power forwards, but he's got the size and strength to deal with the real strong fours around the NBA.
Al Jefferson's checked in for Charlotte. Kid Gilchrist comes in for Gerald Henderson. Then for the Wizards, Nene comes in for Chris Humphreys. And Paul Pierce is subbed in for Otto Porter Jr.
You heard talk last year of the NBA perhaps considering adding a four-pointer as a shot, something you only really see in celebrity games for charity, and it would certainly have had a huge impact if it was implemented, but I think that would be a reach, folks. Let's stay with the three-pointer.
Now here's Kid Gilchrist. Stevenson with a clean look. Offline with his 3. Washington leading now by 13. And Wall kicks to Beal. Nene with the screen on Stevenson. Back to Wall. Pass to Gortat. Second chance shot. No good. Jefferson with some nice D.
They've been able to get out to this lead without really getting a very reliable performance out of him from the field.
Now Wall. It's Pierce on the wing. Gortat with the screen for Pierce. Nene with the screen on Jefferson. Off the screen. That is good. 17 points for Paul Pierce. And guys, to be clear, that four-point line was really just something talked about, whispered about. No real traction, as this is even a remote possibility. At one point, however, the same was said about the three-point shot. And now it's a huge part of the game.
I don't buy it, though, Kevin. I just can't imagine a four-point shot. It would seem to destroy everything that had built up over the course of the game if you just allow a guy to shoot a half quarter for 4 points to win the game. I don't see this happening.
Gortat with the screen for Beal. And the rebound goes to the Hornets.
And the defense did a pretty good job of closing off the middle once he got inside the lane.
And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line. So Kidd Gilchrist will go to the free throw line. That's on Paul Pierce.
Michael Kidd Gilchrist missing 6 weeks last season with a broken hand. And frankly, he took a step back overall.
And Kidd Gilchrist, no good on that one. And a player taken second overall 2 years ago. A lot of pressure hiding on the shoulders of MKG.
You know, sometimes guys fall into draft positions that don't necessarily match their skill level, but you can never question the work ethic of this young man, and you know he's going to maximize whatever he can be as a pro because of that.
Well, good idea setting that screen, but the execution wasn't there.
No, it sure wasn't. I mean, you want it to be hard, but it also has to be legal.
Washington leading now by 15. Beal, the pass to Wall. Kicks to Beal. Gortat inside. And he gets it to go.
He wasn't able to get his name in the score sheet in the first half, but he looks like he's starting to find his comfort zone here.
Wall against Walker. The dish now to Stevenson. And Zeller kicks to Jefferson. Here's Stevenson, and blocked. And it's out of bounds to the Hornets as Charlotte retains possession. And the Hornets call time here. It's been quite a game for Bradley Beal.
He's dialed in from long range. They got to stay in his hip pocket and deny him the catch.
And here is Zeller. Stevenson drives in. And the dunk by Zeller. And that's how you exploit a gap in the D, I guess. Huh?
Yes, sir. No soft finish there. Major power.
He knows an opportunity for the highlight reel when he sees one.
Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over. Cody Zeller, a first-round pick back in 2013, 1 year after his brother Tyler Clark was taken in the first round.
You know, that's happened only two other times in NBA history, Kevin. The Plumlee brothers, Miles and Mason, also taken in 2012 and 13. Miles drafted by the Pacers back in 2012. And then back in 87 and 88, the Grant twins, Horace and Harvey.
And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Thank you, guys. I got a chance to hear what Randy Whitman was saying to the team. He told the players, let's put our foot on them and keep them down. We've got them exactly where we want them. I want to see you guys slow the pace, use the clock, and stay away from any silly fouls.
And you go back to draft night in Charlotte, a borderline fan revolt at the draft party after they selected Zeller. He hasn't quite hushed his doubters yet, but some of the bigger names yet to make an impact either, so we'll see how he develops. You know, his shot's been pretty accurate today, but he has not had his usual share of opportunities.
Stevenson dishes to Kidd Gilchrist, and Gortat with the block. And here's Stevenson for three. Stevenson missing again. Wizards leading by 15. And Wall kicks to Nene. Gortat with a screen on Jefferson. Beal with it. He's picked up by Walker. Lock at six. Nice ball movement by Washington. And the shot's good from Nene.
Well, that just adds to what's probably an already insurmountable lead. I think they'll be walking out of here with a pretty easy victory.
Steve, I think that's a given.
Now, here's Walker to the right side. Here's Jefferson off the left rim and out. Washington has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter.
And this is what they wanted, to announce their presence in this matchup with authority. Very decisive. And I think it can be considered a statement win for the Wizards.
Clark, their shot blocking turned out to give them a big advantage in this game.
Well, they were disciplined and focused, I thought, all game long, Kevin. Excellent defense around the rim.
Depth always a factor in wins like this, and what an incredible game out of nowhere it was for John Wall. And a big part of their success was his ability to keep the ball moving and finding guys when they would flash open.
And Zeller, you know, last season struggled early with his shot. He seemed to turn it around later, though, giving hope for his progress moving forward. I've got a lot of confidence in this young man. I think he's going to be one heck of an NBA player.
Well, since the turn of the century, guys, the Western Conference has ruled the roost, winning interconference matchups in 14 out of the last 15 seasons. So, Steve, last season, the highest ever win percentage for the West at over 72%.
Yeah, and eight of the league's top 10 teams played in the West record-wise. It may be time to take a fresh look at a top 16 playoff structure.
Here's Roberts. There's Neal with the three. It's rebounded by Blair. Washington's gotten the three-point shot off 16 times. It's Beal on the wing. Back to Miller. He feeds it to Beal. Knocked away. One-on-one here. Here's Roberts. And he banks in the layup.
You know, the height difference there is huge, but he canceled it out with great body control in the air.
Exactly, Steve. He got to the hoop and wouldn't allow himself to be manhandled by the big boy.
Now, here is Miller. It's Beal on the wing. Blair, the screen. Porter in the corner. Down to five on the shot clock. Goes up to the stripe. Beal's shot is good. Beal's got 31 points.
A serious game-clinching run. They've taken off here. Impressive.
No backing off. What a surge at the right time.
And so it's Washington easily grabbing this one. Some days, Clark, everything goes right for a team, and they just had one of those games.
Yeah, it certainly was. I mean, these guys played a great all-around basketball game here.
And now we send you down to Doris Burke, courtside, who's with our Jordan Player of the Game. Doris?
Well, first off, John, congratulations on this win. Is the type of tandem that we're seeing with you and Bradley Beal and the performance you had here tonight hinting that this may just be the best backcourt in the league?
I'm not going to say we had the best backcourt in the league, but we're going to be a talented backcourt for years to come with. It's great to play with somebody that can knock down shots like that. He can create, he can push the ball, he defends, and he made the job a lot easier for me. If you want to help, I can find him anytime.
Thank you so much. Back to you guys at the table.
Thank you, Doris. And, folks, that about concludes our broadcast tonight. For Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching as we leave you with our Jordan Player of the Game, John Wall.